If you don't have access to ArcGIS online, then you can use Google to select your sample points. In the SOP, as well as the description on YouTube, you can find this link to UC Davis Soil Web Apps, and then we'll click on Soil Web Earth. This will download the soil web layer that will open in Google Earth, and we want to make sure that the soil web layer is turned on with this checkbox. Some basic navigation in Google Earth is the bar over here. You can zoom in, zoom out. You can also use your scroll on your mouse, and we'll just navigate to a random field. You can also change the angle with these arrows. So once you've located the field that you are wanting to sample, you'll identify the majority soil series, which is these yellow polygons with the number. You can also click within the polygon to see the information on that soil series. So if I'm wanting to sample this field right here, then I'll click on it, and this is within the Skagit series as the majority. So we'll draw a polygon of this majority soil series within that field. You'll click on the add polygon icon on this top navigation bar. Change the name to sample area. Go to measurements and change the area to acres, or just make sure that it's on acres. And now you can draw your polygon by holding the left button on your mouse and dragging it to trace the field boundary within that majority soil series. And once the polygon is drawn, you can click OK. Now, under the Places header, you can right-click, go to Add, and then Folder. And now you will retitle this folder with your sample ID that is provided by WSDA, and then click OK. Under the Places header, hover your cursor, tap Add Folder, and you will retitle this with the sample ID that's been provided by WSDA, and then click OK. Now you can add your 5 sampling points in a W shape to this named folder. Click on Add Placemark, this thumbtack icon, and you can rename your sample points 1 through 5. You'll have 5 sample points within your field, and just make sure to place them within that polygon that you created using the majority soil series. And you'll place these points in a W shape. Make sure that your 5 points are within this folder that's titled by your sample ID. And now you can save and export your sampling points to a KMZ file that will work in Google My Maps. So if you right-click on the folder, click Save Place As. It'll automatically set the file name to your sample ID or whatever you titled your folder. Save it in a location you can access later. And now you'll go to Google My Maps, which is different than Google Maps. You need to have a Gmail login for this. And you'll click Create New Map. And then you can click Import. Select a file from your device and navigate to where you saved that KMZ file. Now your points are in a Google My Map. If you click on the untitled map at the top, you can rename it to the sample ID and click Save. And now this will show up in your Google Maps app on your phone. Open Google Maps and then tap on Saved at the bottom bar, and then tap on Maps, and all of your custom maps that you've created in My Maps will appear here. So you tap on the sample ID that you're trying to navigate to, and it will automatically move you to that location. And you can tap on any of these sampling points to get directions. If you anticipate needing to download this map for offline use, if you don't have service where you'll be sampling, you can go to your main Google Maps page and then tap on your initial on the top right where the search bar is. Tap on Offline Map, select your own map. Now you'll need to navigate to where your fields are that you don't think that you will have service. Tap Download. And now you should have this map on your offline maps area when you're in the field and don't have service. Make sure you do this step before you head out into the field.